Yep. You already know what time it is, man. Get up in here, everybody. Get up in here. And as you come up in here, start pushing that like button. Spam that like button. We need to get to 5K likes before I get to this game. Got the hater blockers on, man. If these drop down to my face, you know I'm trying to evade the haters. You know what I'm saying? Nah, I'm just playing, man. We don't evade the haters. We just remove their voice. We don't really need to hear them talk because they don't ever really have anything productive to say in the conversation, you know? They just do a whole lot of talky-talky. And when you're doing a lot of talking without any depth to what you're saying, it's irrelevant to the discussion. So with that being said, we got to get you out of here because you ain't doing nothing for the people. Yeah, you ain't doing no works. And on the Sabbath day, it won't be tolerated. It won't be tolerated when you want to come up in here and play with the game because this is a very sacred day. This ain't like any other day. Yeah. The Lord is talking to me. I'm the Lord's. The Lord told me that there was a fire amongst you, and I'm the Lord's firefighter, and I've come with righteousness shrouded upon me to put the fire out. But listen, man, I need all of y'all to tap the follow and the bell button. And to my new viewers, let me know where you're from. Comment your city and your state below. And we need to work our way up to 5K likes. In the meantime, we're just going to have a conversation, but I will tell you one thing. If I don't see those likes steadily moving up through the entire time we're having conversations, I will immediately end the live, and we'll start the next episode. And you won't get the game that I'm going to provide this episode. My game is meant to be taken seriously, and that's the only way, in fact, it will be taken, and I will not accept otherwise. If that's understood, I appreciate you. Get on one accord and push that like button. If that's not understood, remain there silent and let these likes not go up and watch what I do. Your entertainment will end. It will cease, and I'll move on to my next thing because when you're productive, it doesn't matter. You always got something else to do. So if you guys want this game, show me you want this game and get these likes to 5K. Square business. Like Kane said, I love this king. Stay beautiful, bro. I appreciate it. I appreciate all the commentary. Yeah. And to the new viewers, tap the follow on the bell button, man. We're locked and loaded and ready to go. We got a lot to talk about tonight. Yeah, we got a lot to talk about tonight. So let's get it going. Let's get it going good. You feel what I'm saying? So everybody push that like button, man. Let's go. And to everybody up in my chat, how you doing? Yeah. How you doing? Address your neighbor. Yeah, we got 6 people in the building. Y'all need to address one another. If you got some question or that you need advice on, this is the perfect time to ask it until we get to 5K likes. Because once we get to 5K likes, I'm going to talk about what I want to talk about. But right now, the mic and the stage is yours. Yeah, so let's socialize. Shout out to Karini Shirini 6. What's good? How you doing? Tap the follow on the bell button. We would love to have you. How you doing? Yeah, let's go. Let's go, man. We got a lot to talk about. And shout out to Hassan Campbell, man. I just want to say that right now because your name will be in this title. I appreciate all the game that you give, and I learned so much from you. And even if people don't agree with everything you say, if people focus on so much of what they don't agree with, they're going to miss out on what they could understand on a whole other level because they're so worried about what they focused on that they disagree with. They feel like that everything else you say is invalid. Truth of the matter is, nobody's ever going to agree with 100% of what you're saying, but you got to keep saying it as if they do. Hey, but don't ask me no question if you ain't follow me. I'm gonna be real with you, Spencer and Karini. If y'all ain't follow me, you ain't got no question to ask me. The only question you should be asking yourself is why the are you in my live if you haven't followed me? Shout out to Karina Shirani. Okay, now ask your question. What's good? I feel more than obliged to answer now. Let's go. We need 2.5K more likes. Let's go. Y'all working hard, man. Yeah, I ain't answering nothing about the UFC. But until you follow me. Yeah, for real. Straight square business, boy, coming up in here and asking for something. You ain't even a part of the family. Yeah, later. Goodbye. Hey, get him out of here, guys. Get him out of here. Escort him immediately out of the door. Peace, Goofy. Get him out. Come up in here asking me what to do up in the game, and you ain't getting nothing to the game. Why men don't want a big girl? I wouldn't say all men don't, but you know, like if someone like me, because look at me, I worked hard to get my physique. So why would I settle for someone who's lazy about theirs? The way that I am is if I start letting go of myself and I get like that, it's not healthy. It's the best definite. Why would you mute her? She asked a serious question. Bro, a snack. Hey, appreciate y'all, man. Make sure y'all tap the follow and the bell button. If you ain't following, tapping the bell button, I ain't got nothing to say to you. But anyways, if you got yourself going right and you physically in shape and you're doing the best definition of keeping your body in check, you're not going to want to settle for no one that's not serious about their physique. That's just a simple fact. Why would a guy that's living his best life, chasing his passions, and working hard to keep his mental and physical strong, why would he settle for someone who's lazy? Because if you're like that, 9 out of 10, unless you have a medical condition, you're just lazy. And I'm going to be real with you. I don't care what society says. It's the truth. If you let go of yourself and you become like Mrs. Puff from SpongeBob, you're just lazy. And you can get it together, man. It's so easy. All y'all got to do is start running. And I know I hurt a lot of people's feelings with that. But yeah, this ain't the feelings Olympics. I could care less. Yeah. Man, keep pushing that like button, man. We at 2.6K likes. We need to get to 5K. Yeah, let's go. I said what I said, man, and that chat got quiet. Hey, man, I'ma always speak the real. That's a fact. I could care less about who feelings I hurt. I never came in this game to make friends, like Kane said. I did not come here to make friends. I came here to give game. Get mad all you want. Think I give a dang, boy? Keep pushing that like button, though. Yeah, mute the goofy. The truth hurts. Shit, the truth hurts, man. But sometimes what hurts you only makes you stronger. That's just a fact. Hey, man, to the new viewers, make sure y'all tap the follow and the bell button so you can be subscribed. Yeah, subscribe to this game. You're spending your time with me on a Friday. One of the most fleshful days that people reside in, man, because they think on this day that they're absolutely supposed to go crazy when they're actually supposed to be taking their time. Fam, just mute. Yeah, you about to get muted, too. Goodbye. Get out of my live, goofy. You should have just kept yourself on mute. Now you're finna get eternally muted. Yeah, don't come up in my live plan. My moderators can do whatever they choose to, and you're going to be in the spirit of silence. So get Mr. Stacy up out of here immediately. Goodbye. Get out of here. Okay, get out. Goodbye. That's all I gotta do. Snap my fingers like I got the Infinity Gauntlet on, and you gone. The freak. Okay, obviously my mods are all in the best definition of sleep. They don't know how to do what they're supposed to do, so I'll do it. Hey guys, I will start removing moderator roles if you guys don't want. There's no reason that I should have over 3 mods in here and nobody got that goofy out of here. Come on now, guys. We need 1.9K more likes, and we'll get to this game. So make sure that y'all keep pushing that like button, and let's keep it going. What y'all also got to understand when it comes to settling, don't settle for no goofies. I could care less if they're a view on my life. If I don't like the energy, I'll get them out of here. Everybody's business isn't good business. You can keep your dollar, and you can keep your intention. If you don't get this game, you ain't supposed to get it. You supposed to be the goofy. Yeah, you missed the goofy. You most surely did. But you ain't the only mod in here. The rest of my mods need to get on one accordance with their job. Otherwise, I'll take the role away. But man, yeah, it's a beautiful day. You know, it's the end to another fast week for me, it feels like. That's another day, man. A lot of y'all be like, every day seems so slow. It's because you're not productive. My days fly by so fast, man. I swear it was just Monday. Now it's, what, Saturday morning? It's insane. It's absolutely insane. 1.7K more likes and we going to get to this game, though. We going to get to this game. Anybody got any flash topics they want me to cover in the meantime? Anybody got any flash topics? If so, I will gladly speak on them. It'd be dope to include it in my title on YouTube. That's just another keyword that I could use. So does anybody got anything that they want to bring to my attention? If not, that's fine. If so, feel free to go ahead and comment. Otherwise, you know, I'm going to just be looking at myself like I'm standing in the mirror. But either way is cool with me. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, this is y'all's time. This is the time where you have the mic. You know what I'm saying? And you can ask the questions that you want perspective on, you know? Because you know I'm going to give it to you straight up. How you feeling about the NFL? Is it worse or better? I think it's, in a competitive standpoint, it's worse because there's so many rules that hinder the physicality of football, but at the same time, it is for the betterment of the health of the football players on the field. So back then, it was a lot more physical and it was a lot more competitive because you knew how much was on the line, where nowadays everybody wants to be buddy-buddy. And don't get me wrong, I understand positivity, but when you're on that field, you're supposed to be playing for a championship. These guys just play for a contract nowadays. They just want money. So when it used to be about, you know, championships and accolades like that, I think it was a better sport. Now it's just about money and fame. I will give you... Yeah, you're not funny. Get out of my life. Goofy. And I just gave you the mute, baby boy. Now you can't talk in my life. No. Yeah, don't play with me, Goofy, because you're going to lose every time. Yeah, nice try, grandson. Maki undefeated, you defeated. Yeah. Play with me, boy. 1K more likes. I appreciate you for asking, by the way, Jeff. You a real one, man. There's 7 people in here. Ain't nobody got anything that they want me to talk about on a Friday night. But another thing, man, if you guys are looking for a Netflix show and you want to, I guess you could say, join me along this journey, I am watching Arrow now. So I'm going to be talking about Arrow, man, and Oliver Queen. I think he's a very interesting character. We're going to learn a lot about this dude, and we're going to see what type of game we can get from him. What type of game we can get, what type of game we can shake and break down so we can give it to y'all. Because, man, there be lessons in these shows, you know what I'm saying? There be real-life lessons in these shows, man. Yeah, for real. 800 more likes, and we up in the building, man. Keep pushing that like button, man. I know y'all working hard. I know your finger hurts. I know your finger's throbbing. I know your finger feel like you be doing wall sits for about 2 hours. But let me tell you, the pain is worth the gain in the game that I'm about to give. I'm just laying the game down on the ground for the hungry hounds who just got out the pound and they're starving for the very next round. Can you talk about the time and process that it takes to be great for future topics to talk about? Anthony, the donate goat up in here. Shout out to Anthony. None of y'all better challenge Anthony to donate, and that's all I gotta say. But it doesn't take a lot of time, and there's really no process, you know? The process was when I grew up socializing with people. Now it's easy. I don't have to think about it, or I write down some, like, a list of topics, things that I'm interested in, but I don't really have to, like, research or anything. Now, it could improve my conversation if I did do research, but all this stuff usually just comes out. So I would just say, man, practice on socializing, and whatever you say, make sure it's what you believe. Quit saying things that other people have put into your head that you haven't come to an understanding upon yourself. Because, man, we got a lot of people that groupthink. A lot of their thoughts is just, it's Bluetooth thoughts from other people. It's literally like you're being, what did they call that? Airdropped. You're airdropped thoughts into your brain, and you're just saying what somebody else thinks. What do I think about Lucifer? The Netflix show or the actual Lucifer? Yo. 100 more likes and we're going to get to this game. I want to answer that question, though. So let me know who you're talking about. The Netflix show or Lucifer himself? Something in the way. Ooh. Just had some crumble cookies. Oh, which one did you like the most? I got the whole box. I got the four pack, not the 6-pack, but I got the pumpkin roll, the M&M one, the chocolate chip one, and then there's one more, I forgot what it's called. Oh, the show. I never finished the show, and I know we talked about this a while ago, but I really like the show. It's really comfortable. Like, you can watch that show in the early morning, it can get your day started, and then you can also watch it late at night, and you can fall asleep to it, and you can also watch it midday. It's a really good show, and it gives you an interesting perspective on how alluring the devil can be, and how, like, logical his thoughts sound, so it would make sense to why he would do some of the things that he did. But it doesn't make sense when you think about the position that he had in heaven. It's like almost like a spoiled kid that was given things his whole entire childhood and then decided to delete his parents. It doesn't make sense. He wasn't neglected or devoid of love. He was given love, but he decided that he wanted to be the giver. He didn't want to be the getter anymore, but he wanted to be the giver in a completely twisted and distorted level. But anyways, we're gonna get to this game, man. So moderators, make sure that you guys keep the chat goofy free. Encourage new people to tap the follow and the bell button, and we're gonna get to this game. Much love to all of you in here, and I appreciate you all for your work, as it was a very long grind to 5K, but we made it here. We climbed that mountain. So what you guys have to understand is when someone comes into your life after you do something great and then they disappear, after a while of you keeping them around and allowing them access to the success that you have, it's not necessarily you, it's that they were using you as a stepping stool. So when that happens, the mistake that I made in the past is I tried to go out to these people that were clearly snakes and pretty much ask them why they snaked me. You sound goofy if you ask a snake why it bit you. A snake is going to bite you, and there's no logical reason behind it besides them seeing you as a meal. They see you as their come up. You see, a lot of people will use you as stairs. They will use you as an escalator. And as soon as they get to where they feel like that they don't need you no more, that's when they'll disrespect you. I could give so many examples, man, of just, you know, the manager artist or label artist or athlete to athlete. There's been so many different examples of someone befriending someone and giving them love and, you know, passing the ball and giving them so many opportunities. And when this person reaches a certain level, they pull the Uno reverse card and disrespect them. And now it's all this and it's all that. And it's like you're biting the hand that feeds you. But why would you be surprised that a snake would bite you? It's not always a sure thing that just because that dude you see walking down the street with a snake around his neck doesn't mean that one day that snake won't decide that he's going to constrict himself around that guy's neck and get rid of him. It's a snake. That's in their nature. So you guys be surprised when a snake does snake things. But the reason that you're surprised is because in the beginning, this person wasn't a snake, or at least they didn't seem so. They shapeshifted. But when they shapeshift into a snake, one thing about it is when someone shows you who they are, don't underlook it. When someone shows you who they are, don't underlook it. People will do the most crazy and mind-boggling things, and you'll be sitting there like, man, I put so much time into this person. I was there for this person at their lowest point. I gave them this. I gave them that. I did this. I did that. And you would think, and you always had thought, that they appreciated it. But now they've taken off the mask and they show you that they were the best definition of fake. And it's very hard sometimes to move on, depending on the duration that you have these people around you. But it's the best thing to do. You see what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, everybody has a level of selfishness. But some people, their selfishness is so strong that they'll use it on people that you wouldn't expect it. And the people that they use it on that didn't expect it, they think that this person loves them when this person is just looking at them like a physical identification of an opportunity. And that's why I say something that I got from Asan Campbell: watch your circle before they hurt you. Because the ones outside of your circle, they can do damage, right? That they can do damage. They can do limited damage. They can do heavy damage. But it's the ones inside of your circle that can do the most damage. So when someone does some snake stuff the first time, quit thinking that they're dinosaurs. Quit thinking that they're lions, tigers, and wolves. When a snake hisses at you, that does not mean that he's a dog. It means that he's a snake. And sometimes when it hisses, it might be a cat. What is a cat? The word that I won't say on this live. So if you're dealing with a snake or a cat, you need to get them from around you. Because when things go left, guess where they're going to be? Not there. Tell me how I'm supposed to breathe with no air. Yeah, they're not going to be around. They're going to take flight. Can we pretend that airplanes in the night? That's where they're going to be. Airplanes in the night sky. While you on the ground dealing with madness, they're going to be in the spirit of gone. They're going to be in the spirit of departure. Spirit Airlines, we are now boarding the plane. Yeah, they're not going to be there anymore. Because they fulfilled their role. And now they're going to move on to the next person. They look at you as a snake would look at a mouse. A meal, a lick, a snack. Watch your circle before they hurt you. Shout out to Asan Campbell. Now I'm going to take the time to read the comments pertaining to the subject. If anybody has anything that they want to add, go ahead and comment it now. Then after that, I'm going to conclude this episode and I'm going to get on to episode number 3. Shout out to everyone that's here. It's Friday night. I know you guys have a lot of time, so I want to see you in the next episode. But if you can't make the next episode, I'll see you tomorrow. I'm back. What's good, Tyler? Yep, same. The show just has... Okay, so no one said anything. That's fine again. So, guys, I hope that you live as long as you want and never want as long as you live. To the new viewers, make sure that you tap the follow on the bell button and we'll be right back. Peace.